Hi there, this video we're going to draw custom icons in XD. We're going to use something called the Boolean operator, and we're going to draw this little account man. You click him and view your account. It's super easy. Let's jump in now and work it out. All right, one of the drawing techniques in Adobe XD is something using Boolean operators. That's a really weird word for using shapes to cut out other shapes, kind of like a cookie cutter. Or if you've used Adobe Illustrator before, it's like the Pathfinder. Or the shape builder tool. So I'm using the ellipse tool. I'm gonna hold down shift. It gives me a perfect circle when I draw it out. And I'm gonna draw a couple of shapes. So I'll grab you. And I'm gonna draw one more. You could copy and paste it. Okay, so actually I just want these two. And I'm gonna overlap them a little bit. So with them selected, you've got these four options. These four Boolean operators. There's add, subtract, they've all got shortcuts, intersect, and overlap. So I'm gonna have 1, 2, 3, 4 versions. First one, add, ready? Boom, easy, draws, connects them both. This one here, two separate circles. This one here uses whatever's at the front. Okay, so this one's called subtract, is it? Subtract, yep, it uses whatever's at the front to subtract from the back. And if that role is reversed, if I bring this large one to the front and do the exact same operator, okay, it'll use the front one to chunk out the back. So you just gotta be, not careful, but you just gotta know what you know, have the one at front that you want to use as the slicer. This one here, let's have a look. So this one intersect, is it? Intersect, so just wherever they overlap is what's left, and this last one here will cut a hole where they overlap. Now that's all well and good, and that's cool. You can build lots of shapes this way, and that's how we're gonna build that login guy. You can see quite easily how we're gonna do it. What's really cool about these operators is that they're non-destructive. Even though that looks like a legit kind of shape, watch this, if I double click the circle, you see? Still kind of like a thing, okay? This one here, if I double click it, you can see this one here is actually kind of a non-destructible shape. So it actually, it's still editable. That's a better way of saying it. Double click them and kind of jump in, you can kind of make adjustments. So it's really handy, really cool. Not a one-way street. All right, so what I wanna do is draw our little account man. So I'm gonna do two circles, I'm gonna select both of them, I'm gonna line them up, okay? And I find I end up drawing like little snowmen. accounts people, come on, account. I'm squinting my eyes thinking, oh, is that the right size proportionately? That looks all right. So I'm gonna join these two together. Okay, so I'm gonna go kaboom. So they're one little unit. And then I wanna slice the bottom off. And I'm going to, so you can do more than one. These were just kind of one action. We're gonna do two. So I'm gonna grab this, select these two, and then, which one do I want? Have a guess. Subtract, that's the one. Okay, and because this rectangle's at front, boom, we can kind of draw them off. Okay, is it an account, man? It's close enough. Anyway, look good in my head. And when I practiced it before this course, it looked better, I promise. So I'm gonna scroll it down or shrink it down to an appropriate size. I'm gonna zoom in and I'm gonna get it so it fits in here. Cool. And now I want to kind of zoom out and see, I'm gonna go command one and work out what size I want in terms of the stroke. So I'm gonna have no fill, I'm gonna have a border of white, and I'm gonna crank up this border size to 2. That feels about right. And the cool thing about it, remember, if you're like, oh, that guy, double click it. Okay, keep double clicking until you find the bits you need. And am I gonna make this guy better? It's a bit better, here you go. I like it better anyway. Command one. And that, my friends, is how to do basic things with, yeah, those Boolean operators. Now there's tons of things you can make by subtracting and minusing and dividing. That means you don't have to dig around in the pen tool. We'll look at the pen tool a little bit later on, which is a lot more complicated if you haven't used it before. All right, let's get on to the next video. Hi there, I hope you enjoyed the video. My name is Daniel Scott. If you would like to do the full course, there'll be a link in the description for that. Please give this video on YouTube here a thumbs up, it really helps me and what I'm doing. Also consider subscribing to the channel. I release a video like this every week for your viewing pleasure. All right, bye.